Welcome to Mongoose channel. In this video, we will demonstrate how to limit all network functionality to a preallocated memory pool. This ensures that network memory usage does not exceed a predefined boundary. First, we will create a simple dashboard with LED toggling functionality. Then we will confine Mongoose to a constrained memory pool and add a memory usage graph to visualize memory usage in real time. I will be using an STM32 development board, but any other device would work exactly the same. Visit mongoose.ws and open Mongoose Wizard. Start a new project. Select the target directory where the generated project will be stored. Choose the target architecture, Nucleo-F756ZG, but you can use any other board. The procedure will be identical. We could use Zephyr or Cube as the build environment, but let's stick with the bare metal makefile to keep things quick and simple. Choose a single LED toggle dashboard, click Next, and click Finish. Click Generate. The wizard creates a bare metal project in your output directory. Start a serial console. Run make build flash to build and flash the binary. Open the IP address in the browser and see the dashboard served by our device. This board has three LEDs, so let's implement the LED toggling functionality. Open the REST API editor, add LED2 and LED3 to the LED's endpoint, and add toggle buttons for LED2 and LED3. Open Settings, set the integration mode to existing project, and set the auto update interval to 1 second. Click Generate. Copy the LED's API implementation from mongooseglue.c to main.c. Change the glue prefix to a different prefix and update the implementation to read and write the LED GPIOs. Call Mongoose set HTTP handlers to tell Mongoose to use our handlers. Rebuild and reflash the project. Now we can toggle LEDs directly from the dashboard. It's time to confine TCP IP networking to a preallocated memory pool. At runtime, Mongoose uses the mgcalloc function to allocate memory and mgfree function to release it. By default, these simply call the C library calloc and free functions. Since many connections can exhaust memory and interfere with the device's business logic, Mongoose allows the user to provide custom implementations of mgcalloc and mgfree. Open the Mongoose documentation and navigate to build options. There is a build time constant, mg enable custom calloc. Set it to 1 in mongooseconfig.h. When we rebuild the firmware, the compiler will complain that mgcalloc and mgfree are missing, so we need to implement these two functions. We could implement them exactly as default implementation does by using the C library calloc and free. But instead, let's use a custom memory allocator with a predefined chunk of memory. There are many good implementations of embedded memory allocators. For example, FreeRTOS provides the heap 4 and heap 5. There is also UMM malloc and others. In this video, we will use O1 heap, which is an impressive implementation that executes in constant time. Copy the header and source files into our project. In the main function, allocate a 50 kilobyte memory pool for networking. Initialize the O1 heap allocator using that memory pool, making sure to provide an aligned address. In mgcalloc, call O1 heap allocate. In mgfree, call O1 heap free. Add O1 heap.c to the list of source files in the makefile. Rebuild and reflash the project. It works. Now, let's visualize memory usage. In the Settings tab, enable WebSocket. In the REST API, add a new data endpoint called Stats with two numeric attributes, RAM-free and NUM connections. Make the endpoint read-only. Add a new panel for the memory usage graph. insert a graph element and bind it to the RAM free value. Set the graph maximum to 50,000. Add another graph and bind it to the number of connections, with the maximum set to 20. Click Generate. In main.c, override the stats_getter function. Retrieve the memory statistics, set the RAM free value, and calculate the number of active connections. Finally, call mongoose AWS reporter to report the stats values every 200 milliseconds. Rebuild and refresh the project. Now we can see the real-time graphs. The free memory is around 25K. Running curl shows that the number of connections is 6 and the free RAM is about 24K. These 6 connections are 1 HTTP listener, 1 HTTPS listener, 3 from the web UI, 1 fetching static files, 1 performing periodic status checks, and 1 WebSocket connection. And finally, the curl request itself. Let's add another UI window. Now we can see that the number of connections has climbed to 9 and the free RAM has dropped to 17K. This means that each connection consumes a little over 2 kilobytes of RAM. Keep adding new windows until memory is exhausted. We see an out of memory message in the log. However, the server continues to operate. Delete the extra windows, and we see that the free RAM climbs back up while the number of connections drops. That's it for today. We learned how to use a custom memory allocator for networking to keep network memory usage within bounds, and we also displayed usage statistics in real time on the device dashboard. Hit like and subscribe if you found this video useful. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.